The enemy goes on, brings one after another. First he brings maybe the spirit of smoking cigar, spirit of drinking alcohol and talking, speaking ill of others. Slowly spirit of prostitution, spirit of all, one by one. They go on, tie him, tiger. So the first thing to bind us, the enemy will say, we don't need your knowledge. We don't need your ways. What, mummy? Going on praying. Stop praying. What is this? If you want, you go and pray. No, son. If you want me, I have seen you dying in your sin. If you don't pray, if you don't have light, what is left out is darkness. If I am your mummy, if I am your daddy, I have to lead you. If you love me, this is the way. We have to show. That's why a beautiful sentence is given in the book of Proverbs, chapter 22, verse 6. Train up a child in the way he should go. Train up the child not as you wish to go, or as you desire to go, or as the child wants to go. No. The word of God says, train up the child in the ways he should go. There is a way for the child to go, which God has kept. And when he is old, he will not depart from it. When he becomes old, so when he is young, you show what is the way of the Lord, and then he will not go. We continue Job chapter 21. What are the ways through which the enemy binds man? Removing him from holiness, removing the person from the presence of God. Verse 15. Who is this Almighty that we should serve him? And what profit do we have if we pray to him? The next thought the enemy will bring to defile you, to take away the holiness from you, to bind you in bondage. What he will teach you? He will put this kind of thought. What is this Almighty? We should serve him. What profit will I get? If I pray, will I get this? If I work only, I can man. If I don't work, will you feed? Will anybody give me money? This kind of thoughts the enemy will put. What profit will I get if I pray? Simply you are going on telling me, pray. I caught up and prayed. I went for the Sunday mass enough. Mummy, please don't disturb me. Daddy, please don't do. Why? The enemy is roaring like a lion. All that he wants is to bind us and bind our children. We get fed up. I let him go whatever he wants. No, you and I are given a mission till the end of our life. The body, if it is given to the evil, it can become instruments of destruction. On the other hand, the same body, if it is given to God, according to Romans 12:2, offer your bodies as a living sacrifice to God, the same body will become power, instruments of power, instruments that will destroy the evil. Yes, in the book of Exodus chapter 16, when Moses raised the hands for many hours, as long as the hands were raised up, the enemy Amalekites were destroyed. We read in the book of Daniel chapter 6 verse 10. As long as the knees of Daniel were on prayer, the lions could not even come near Daniel. He bound the mouths of the lion. Every organ of yours, your body, if it is given to the holiness, If it is moving with the presence of God, it has decided, I made it clear whether I anything achieve or not. This one thing I will achieve. What is that? I will always glorify God through whatever I talk, whatever I do, wherever I go, let anything happen. I will glorify my God. That is the purpose of my life. If you make it, you will see every instrument, even the moment you look at people, people will get repentance. They will be crying. Your body will be a mighty vessel. No wonder they are taking the parts of St. Anthony all over the world. Because that part has lived for God. That's what we read in the book of 2 Kings. Once some people brought a dead man to Elisha, and they found Elisha is already dead. So they did not know what to do. Then some people said, why can't you go and pray to the graveyard? So those people are carrying the graveyard. It was a lonely place. Some thieves, they saw four people are going slow, so we can catch these four people. Their pockets will be full. So they wanted to catch. So they, by the time they reached the graveyard, they saw the thieves are coming. They left the dead body on the graveyard of Elisha and they ran away. The moment the bone of this dead man touched the graveyard of the great holy man Elisha, that fellow also got life. He also started to run. That's what the Bible says. The presence of God. Your body can become a mighty vessel of God. You need not search anywhere. You offer your body in holiness to your God. There is no other greater power than you. Wherever you go, you will become instruments of healing and deliverance. And that is the desire of God. That is the greatest achievement. You can give it to the Lord to glorify God, that you have protected yourself from the power of the enemy. And you moved all your life around the presence of God. And you have surrendered your life to do the will of God. Yes. That's what we read here in Job says, when the evil attacks, they say in verse 15, who is this Almighty? What profit we get out of it? This is the evil thought the enemy will bring into the life of the children of God and keep the Lord away from their lives, whereby the enemy will bind them with sickness, with bondage, with all kinds of evil. And then third technique we'll go through. Verse 16. Indeed, their prosperity is not in their hand. The moment they fall into the hands of the enemy, all that God gave it to them will be used by the enemy. Used for the enemy. When the prodigal son went away from the father, took all the money of the father, the enemy, what did he do? He removed all the money. All the money which the father, prosperity, everything is gone for the evil. For the evil world to drink, to move around with the prostitutes, to play cards, to go and watch this and that, go here, there. All that is gone. He comes to realize at the end of his stage, as long as what the father gave him was with him, he had food. The moment he lost, made it zero of what he got from the father, he was thrown into the pigs. Even what the pigs were getting, they were not getting. They will get plenty of money, but when you play around, their bank account will become zero. Your prosperity. He will show As long as you have a job, you have a big business, you have a car, you move around, this and that. But everything will become just sucked out by the enemy. And next is, the counsel of the wicked is far from me. The counsel of the Lord will not be available for them. When you move away from the Lord, the counsel, God's counsel, God guiding, we read in Psalm 37, I will keep my eyes over your eyes and I will counsel you. We read in the book of Isaiah chapter 30 verse 20 to 22, it is written that though you eat the bread of suffering and the water of affliction, your God will not simply throw you away. He will talk to you from within. This is the way. Walk in it. Yes, God will continue to. When you move with Him, problems will move with you. But God will talk and counsel you, lead you. But when you move away from the presence of God, when you move away from the holiness, when you defile yourself, when you allow the enemy to defile you, what will happen? The counsel of the Lord will be heard no more.